So I'm Farazat Ahmad. So I'm a technical lead at WSO2, and predominantly throughout my days in WSO2, I've been working on the identity and access management domain. And currently I'm focusing on the product management aspect of the WSO2 identity server and other identity access management products. So to start the talk, so in the present world, like if we think about identity, now the identity is just not limited to individuals or real persons. It is every person or every device, every service or every entity that we interact with in the digital world has a managed identity in addition to their physical identity. So, and the digital identity, if you think about it, it is not limited to just attributes or behaviors. It is also about your interaction. And when we talk about customers and when they interact with your businesses, they too have some sort of a digital identity during their interactions. And when we talk about digital identity experience for customers, we definitely need to talk about this topic of CIA. Traditionally, you would know that IAM is all about giving the right people the right amount of access for the right resources for the right amount of time. So I know the definition kind of sounds a bit cliche, but that would like term the area better. But is CIAM just doing the same thing for the customers? So I would say no, because in traditional IAM, it's the focus on experience is a bit less. But when we put customers, a group of users who are very impatient and kind of like want a near perfect experience, and if the experience is not smooth, they would not hesitate to switch to alternatives. So when we talk about CIAM, so we would like to frame it as an IAM experience that you give to the customer, a great IAM experience. But at the same time, businesses want to leverage the identity data and business data to improve that experience. So it is a combination of IAM plus business value that is gained by leveraging the identity data. And when we talked about building digital identity experiences, we always talk about this simple, secure, and seamlessness. So ever wondered why? So as I said, customers are a bunch of people who want a near perfect experience. So a perfect example was when about a week back, WhatsApp went down. Like it was out for about a few hours. And during that time, two things happened. One, the value of shares and revenue of Facebook went down, as well as the competitors of Facebook and WhatsApp started gaining a lot of installs and traction. So that was, so if you compare the installs on a regular day on that particular day, it has gone by leaps. And with COVID, I think this was discussed in a few of the keynotes. So with COVID, more and more customers are trying to interact with businesses digitally. And the digital adoption is no longer kind of like an optional for businesses. So that adoption has accelerated by a factor that we never predicted. Also, businesses are trying to put out their products and services in a partial or fully digitized form. So based on this survey, it could be seen that it's the same across all regions. So businesses are trying to reach the customers in digital form. And also, like many industries that previously pre-COVID who thought a digital presence is an optional one have started to rethink their strategy and trying to beat the competition by making their digital presence felt. And also, when we talk about customer digital experience, so a customer digital experience is all the experiences that a customer would get related to his digital identity. And with the digital transformation of businesses, the digital identity experience also becomes a key part. And when you consider the journey, so it's not something that happens overnight. So it's a gradual journey from an initial state to give the maximum experience for the user. So when during our interactions with customers and a lot of leads, what we found out was that businesses are in different stages of this maturity, the transformation. So we would like to term that as CIA maturity. And when we looked at the businesses, they are at different levels and trying to transition to the next level. So if you talk a bit about the maturity model, so most businesses, the small businesses, are at level zero. At this level, they are not worried about any customer interactions, and they probably don't have an online portal, and they don't do any sales online. So most of the sales happen offline, and they don't worry about login. So it's sort of like a very primitive system. So most small businesses and family businesses and kind of very small businesses are in this stage. And when we move on to level one, then the businesses only worry about having the customers onboarded, and they will digitally manage the identities up to some extent. So there could be an identity management system in place. Users can sign up and access their services online. But still, even at this stage, it's just about getting an identity, and there is no CRM system, and the businesses do not worry much about the customer preferences. Then when we move on to the next level, at this level, it's a step forward from the traditional managed identity phase. This is where businesses start to look to track a customer's interactions. And so they move on to integrating with a CRM system, a marketing platform, an e-commerce platform, and so on. So at this stage, although the customer interactions are tracked, they are in isolation. So each system has some sort of a data, and if you want to get a cross view across all the systems, then you need to put a lot of manual effort. And also, if you want to generate a report on demand, it will be a very high labor intensive process. And the next stage is another step forward from the siloed phase. So at this phase, it's connected. All the systems that contain the customer's interactions are connected. So businesses can easily generate reports on demand to track the customer interactions. And based on that, they can make business decisions that will further enhance the digital experience. And at the ultimate or the topmost stage, a business is fully optimized in terms of CIM maturity. So they'll have omni-channel access, where customers are interacting with the business through multiple channels. And also they have dashboards, and they have insights about the customer's interaction, not just related to their identity interactions, but also with how it affects their business. So during Asanka's talk, Asanka said, building a good digital experience is not about throwing a bunch of products into the mix and expecting it to work. So building a great digital experience means that you have to understand the customer and his interactions, and then use the existing tools to build that experience. So everything pointing to digital world, this digital experience becomes a key component for adaption. So I really like this picture a lot. So there's a saying that success is like an iceberg. So the meaning is that people only see a small portion of it, but there's a lot going on behind the scenes to actually give that experience. So identity experience are, in my opinion, similar. So there's a lot going behind the scenes, but the customer will only see a part of it. So if everything works seamlessly, they will not appreciate much. So they expect things to work as smooth as that, right? So let's see what are the key ingredients in building a great digital identity experience. So as Asanka said, like, it's not just about throwing a bunch of tools or picking up a set of features from some product and assuming that it works. So building a digital experience means you have to focus on each different types of identity experiences your customer will have and design them so that they'll have a great experience. So the most critical or the most probably the first interaction a customer will have is when they onboard to use your service. So this is where you want to make sure that you want to onboard the customer, but at the same time make it frictionless so that they start consuming and adopting your service without a barrier. So let's see how we can do to make this experience better. So one is to avoid this sign up walls. A sign up wall is when somebody tries to access a service, you ask them to create an account, forcefully ask them to create an account. So in most cases, if you force a user to create accounts, they'll most probably leave your service and pick an alternative. So whereas you can craft it in a different way by allowing the user to log in with a temporary account or a one-click sort of a login with a temporary ID, and then make him use the service. And when they try to exit or move away from your service, you can present them the value. So for example, let's say you allow them to try out your system, and when they want to leave, you can say, okay, you have done great. But if you want to save the things that you have done, you can create an account. So at that time, if you show the customers the value, they'll be most tempted to create an account. Also, the other thing that customers or users generally don't like is when you ask too much information when you onboard them to your system. So a survey on customer onboarding shows that 86% of users say that if the sign up form is too long, more than 11 fields or so on, 86% of the users will abandon the registration and pick a different option. So reducing the fields from 11 to 4 has increased the conversion rate about by 120%. So what we need to do is try to get the minimal data in onboarding, and later we can gather the other data. And the other option to build this, make the experience smooth, is to allow users to bring their own identity. So users typically now, when we take, will have their preferred identity provider, they will have already have their accounts. So during sign up, you can always have options to allow them to come to your system with one of those identities, prefill the sign up form and create an account. Or there's another option or way to build this experience is by letting them log in with their own identity and create an account on the fly. So this is where a different features of a CIAM solution can be useful, but you have to craft the experience. For businesses, making the customer onboarding flow smooth will ensure that there'll be great adoption. And when the next most important experience is the login experience. So you want the login experience to be seamless. At the same time, you don't want to compromise the security. So 40% of around US customers are interested in passwordless authentication. Now the world is moving towards passwordless authentication. So passwords have been like a pain point for more users for a long time. Now the world is trying to eliminate passwords and allow users to log in without password. So you can also adapt when you're crafting the experience. You can also allow users to eliminate passwords and log in with options like passwordless, or you can allow options like social login or federation. Basically, you want to allow users to use their existing credentials to log in. And also when they interact with different part of your businesses, you don't want them to be logging in repeatedly. So you want them to be seamlessly logged in. This is where features like single sign-on come into play. And also, the other part is when you want them to log in, you need to make sure that they have the native authentication experience. So I think in Pamod, in his talk, explained that each device has some sort of a native login experience. So if we take a phone, the native experience is either by authenticating using a mobile, using a biometric, like a fingerprint, or using push-based. So the same thing won't work for other channels. So based on the channels the user is interacting with, you should try to make the login experience native. And we know for strong custom authentication, multi-factor authentication has been the way. But in order to make this experience better, you have to pick the correct multi-factor authentication based on the channel. For example, if you pick email OTP on a mobile, that's a bad UX. For mobile, the most suitable MFA would be SMS OTP or maybe a fingerprint based authentication. And also what we have noticed is that we need to go beyond the traditional MFA. When we talk about login experiences, users are no longer, like, they don't no longer want to be hit by barriers when they try to log in. So based on the risk, we need to evaluate the risk, and only then we need to ask them for stronger authentication option. And omnichannel experience has become an expected experience when you craft login experiences. Next is self-service. So more and more businesses are trying to enable users to do stuff on their own. So when it comes to identity interactions, so it's the same thing. You want to remove manual approvals as much as possible. So when the number of users increase, businesses have to scale. And the easiest way to scale would be to allow users to do things on their own whenever possible. So self-care portals or allowing users to recover or reset their passwords on their own are some of the options you could use to craft this experience. And then an important part of the digital identity experience is a progressive user profile. So user profile is not just about personal identifiers. It's beyond that now. It's about interactions and preferences. But you don't want to burden the user with asking all the information at once. So as we told, as we talked about, during sign up, you want to get the minimal information. But when you make the customer happy, you can get vital information from them at different parts of your interaction. So if you show the value of something, customers are more tend to give vital information to you. And if you ask the information at the inappropriate time, there's more than a high chance that they will give you unreliable data. So progressive profiling is a technique that we can use to enhance this experience. And also, the user profile is not just about the digital identity or identity system. It's also about how you integrate with other systems and how you allow information or user attributes to flow from other systems. So sometimes your user might not directly interact with your CIAM solution or identity management system, but they would interact with a different system, but you want that information to be passed to their profile. So next, so this is a sort of an experience or part of building this digital experience that people tend to overlook. So privacy and consent are very, very important things when it comes to digital experience. So with so many breaches that are happening, so you don't want to have information that are unnecessary. So the less private information you store, the less risk you have. And with these compliances like GDPR coming up, so if there's a breach, there's a high impact on your business and your reputation. And for an example, Yahoo, so a few years back, Yahoo had a set of account use information breaches. and the company lost about 350 million. And in the end, they had to lower their sales price, which eventually led them to sell their email and digital services. So you want to give the users the right tool to like manage what they want to share with you and what they want to share with other applications. And also you want to give them the capability to revoke consent, or maybe have a self capability to govern the consent. Yeah, so we talked about the different type of experiences. So in order to build these experiences, as you would have noticed, there are certain parts of CIM solution that come into play. And so a bit, so I thought it would be nice if we have a bit stories about the experiences, how people saw the value of this identity experiences and how they crafted them. So this comes from one of our customers called Schweizer Alpen Club. So they are a customer based in Switzerland, and they had a website for offering a wide range of services for mountain sport enthusiasts. So initially they had a lot of identity information scattered across different systems. And when the users tried to interact with their portals and services, they had to repeatedly log in. So they decided to enhance this experience, and they wanted their users to like seamlessly log in across their services and access all the services without much friction. So what they did was they digitally transformed their identity data and consolidated them into a single system. And then they offered the great experiences like single sign-on and allowed users to bring their own identity as well. So that allowed, that increased the user satisfaction, as well as the business also got a benefit, because a lot of people started using their systems, and the experience was also smooth. And this story comes from another customer who is who has a popular hotel and casino chain. So their problem was that they had a large number of identities once again scattered across their chain. So the business actually could not have and even the same guest, when they arrive at different places in the chain, they will be duplicating their profile. So business could not have a unified view of their guests. So what they thought was to change that whole experience. So they moved from a P2P integration system to an API-centric solution, and they built they wanted to build a unified profile of the guest. And also, while doing that, they also gave out all the other nice to have features like SSO and so on. So in Asankar's talk, he mentioned that so to do these transformations and build these experiences, either you have to build, buy, or die. So when it comes to very small businesses or businesses that are in the initial stage of digital transformation, so they are looking for the building blocks or to build the experience. But the problem is they do not have enough CIM expertise to build this. So that's what we see in this trend when we look at the Forrester Wave report, that more and more traditional IEM vendors are trying to move into the CIM space. So they want to enable tools for these small businesses to quickly adapt to the quickly adapt and build digital experiences. And also we have seen that adapting CIM tools and building great digital identity experiences have returns to the business in terms of revenue as well as productivity. So with this in mind, we have envisioned a platform that does not only solve the problem partially, but enables a business to move through the maturity model. So as Asankar announced, the one of the key components of this vision is Asgardio. So Asgardio focuses on small businesses predominantly who do not have the expertise in CIEM, but have developers. So, as what Ascardio basically will do is to build in the CIEM best practices and enable tools so that the developer doesn't have to worry about the CIEM aspects and bringing in the CIEM functionality. They will only focus on building, using the tools and building the login experience. So they build the login experience and then move on to focus on their business need. So the rest of the things will be enabled by Ascardio. And for our on-prem users, we do have the identity server. And also, so lots of customers, they have started the digital transformation journey at different phases of the maturity, but they have seen the value of the building this digital experience. So they are planning to move ahead in the maturity model by building these experiences. So in terms of future trends, so what we see is that although we call these future trends, with COVID, actually these trends have been accelerated, I would say. So real life omni-channel experiences is something that we predict will come soon in future, where the businesses will try to pull data from different channels, like integrating with IoT devices and other devices, and try to give value to the customer, for example, like location-based recommendation and so on. And also AI and machine learning is also becoming a very integral part of the CIEM solution and the digital experience. So machine learning is going to be used more and more in fraud detection, threat detection, and so on, adaptive authentication in future. And we have seen CXO dashboards even now, but it will be more real time in future. So I would like to conclude by saying, building a great digital experience is a journey which all the businesses have to take in future.